enough film in these cameras?
Yeah, nochmal.
Actually, I like flying a lot. But unfortunately, airplanes pollute the environment a lot. How can we reduce the pollution that is caused by the airplanes? One solution would be to totally stop flying, which is not so favorable. Another solution would be to make the airplane lighter. We can do so, for example, by making the body of the airplane from a material which is equally strong but weighs less. This and similar research questions can be answered by looking very closely at the materials. If we look very closely, we see that the materials are built from the tiny building blocks that we call microstructures. The arrangement of these tiny building blocks is heavily correlated to the material properties. By studying and understanding them, we can improve the properties such as the strength of a metal. There are various tools and techniques available to help us look at the materials. For instance, now we have electron microscopes. Traditionally, we were using light microscopes, but the newer and cooler microscopes use electron, and this allows us to resolve much smaller features. These modern microscopes, however, have usually two problems. Firstly, they get the data from a really small part of the sample. So if you want to get the data from a larger part of the sample, we need to spend much, much more time. Another problem is that we need to prepare our samples. If we put a part of random material under the microscope, we cannot expect to get high-quality data from it. That's why we scientists spend a lot of time in the lab to prepare our samples to the desired parameters that is needed for the microscopes. Here at MPIE, we have developed a setup to address these two challenges. It is called robot microscope. In the robot microscope, the samples are polished and prepared automatically. Then a robotic arm takes the sample and moves it to the microscope. And then microscope automatically collects the data from the surface of the sample. So if you want to get the data from other part, what should we do? The robotic arm takes the sample back, removes a layer of it, and then repeats the process. Once we have the information from different layers of the sample, we can stack them together, and this would be a 3D information of the microstructure. The advantages of having the robot microscopes are abundant. It can prepare the sample exactly the way we want, and it is also reproducible. By doing so, it can collect the 3D data from a large part of the samples. It also works continuously. It means it works during the weekends and also at nights, and it doesn't need a cup of coffee every 2 hours like I do. Thanks to the robot microscope, the scientists will have more time to focus on the actual problem and developing the advanced materials. Hopefully, as a result of this and similar research, we can continue to enjoy flying also into the future.